somebody find his baby? Did you find your baby? Okay, you enjoy that. I'll leave you guys be. I'll leave you boys at it.
Welcome back. Today we're going to talk about brands that are worth a lot of money, but also different logos you need to be looking out for, or even logos on your brands that's going to make those items worth a lot more money. Now, Travis Matthew, normal polo is $25. But if you get that Travis Matthew logo on the collar, that turns it into a tour edition polo, and it goes from $20-$25 to $50+.
Like magic.
So another thrift store I like to frequent to source sometimes is called Uptown Cheapskate. Now it's another thrift store where they think they know everything. They high price their items, $70 for Nike shoes, even stuff like $50 for a Lululemon jacket. We also have items that they're going to overprice, like Travis Matthew, $25 for a polo. But they don't catch everything. Now this, it looked just like Coogi, but it said Soul of Australia. But in my mind, Coogi's an Australian brand, and I know that. So I'm going to dig a little deeper. Right away on the zipper, we see Coogi. Now, as you guys can see the comps, this is crazy, but I want a little bit more information. Flip the tag right there. This product is a Coogi Australian copyright design. It's so funny to me how they can miss something so obvious like this, but this is flawless, psychedelic design. Should be an easy $200. Do they have it like 40 like the other items? They had this for $16. Wow, so when I took it home, you know, I just wanted to show you guys all the tags so you can see how authentic this is. This product is a Coogi Australian copyright design. All rights are reserved on the material tag. Also, the front tag, same thing. We're going to have that Coogi copyright. We also have the Coogi on the zipper. What a great find, but it actually was not the only one at this store. And at this trip, they missed another item. Now, Ralph Lauren. They thought this was just another Ralph Lauren, but this is double RL. They thought it was Ralph Lauren BL. I don't know what that is, but for $17, it's an easy $100 plus shipping. Definitely, guys, thrift stores miss things. I know it can be frustrating sometimes with some of the overpriced thrift stuff, but this is when we get to make our money.
So funny. So $40 for Lululemon, $25 for Travis Matthew, but $17 for Coogi. All right.
We're back. We're making another stop at our Halo Puppy thrift store that all rights go to dogs and animal rescue. They had a dollar bin, and they had just about my favorite brand of sneaker to sell, especially this model. Now, this is Tiger Woods 15, model 15. I just found another pair a couple weeks ago. These guys were at $1. And if you can see the comps plus the condition, they're really good shape. Should be a pretty easy, quick $80 to $90. So we're already good on this trip. I also found another pair of, or not another pair, but another pair of shoes, I guess. New Balance Industrial. These were great. The bottoms were great. There was ripping in the back, though, in the heel. And we don't buy shoes with ripping in the heels, so I ended up putting those back. But what I did grab was a very nice condition Xbox 360 controller with the battery pack still on it. Now what you want to do, the only real thing here after testing it is just making sure that there's no, or before testing it, is making sure there's no, you know, stuff in the batteries, any of that mold or whatnot it gets. I found a bag that didn't have a price, but it was a really nice Kipling travel rolling bag. The comps were amazing, you know, 100% sell-through rate. And this bag was in really good shape, so basically my only thing to do after fully testing it, you know, making sure all the zippers were working, wheels are working, all that fun stuff, is just go inside and get myself a price.
You all ready?
Yes, so just real quick, I'm gonna put one pair of shoes back.
Okay.
This didn't have a price, so if you can figure that guy.
Okay, cool, thank you.
Of course. Let me just put these back real quick outside.
About $5 on the back.
Yeah, that works.
So this is the part of the video where the logo game goes really strong. Now, Grayson, already a phenomenal brand. This is probably like a $70, $80 quarter zip, but it was the Winged Foot Golf Club. That's the logo. Learn your logos. Winged Foot Golf Club.
is gonna get me a lot more money for this item, but this is the real good score. Not this, this is Ralph Lauren RLX. Decent $25-$30 seller, but this. Now, Peter Millar Quarter Zip XL, typically like $40 to $50 pre-owned, great item. Nonetheless, paying $10 after discount, but this is what we're looking for. Los Angeles Country Club is a rare one to find, and that bumped this up double the price, $90 plus shipping, sold the same day. So those kind of things can really make a big difference when listing your items. You don't want to sell yourself short. Another kind of example, this $8 FootJoy polo. This turned from $25 to around $45 just because of the design. I love buying baseball gloves, but I don't normally buy kids' gloves, but this one made an exception, a left-handed throwing catcher's mitt. Good model, good sell-through rate. They wanted six, and it's gonna sell for around $50. And we got one more item to finish up at this store, and it's another Peter Millar, but I'm always picky when I do buy them. $15 is what they wanted, but $12 for me after discount. A quilted reversible vest should be a quick and easy $50. So we got a couple more bolos before we do finish off today. I'm learning bike seats, saddles, whatever you want to call it. This is a WTB Pure. They wanted $6. I actually already sold it for $26, I think, plus shipping. Really good quick sale there. Another fun one, you know, $11 after discount, but it was a brand new Inbox Echo Dot from Amazon. Great item, completely brand new. Checked it, already sold it, $33 plus shipping. It had a little battery base as well, but it was for a different model. But I did pick it up as well because it got me to that $20 and 20% off at this store with these three items. And it should go for around like $17, $18. So we'll take that. It should pay for everything. I did in a Goodwill find this Wrangler Vintage Aztec Pearl Snap Western. Now, not 100% sure if it was a brush popper, but I did sell it already without that in the listing for $60 plus shipping, and I paid around $7 after discount. We did have one more stop. I went into my consignment store because you guys need to see this brand. It looks like a swan is the logo, and you can't really see what it is, but it's Outlier New York City. This was a wool dress shirt. I paid $36 and sold it for $95. And if you want to check that inside tag, that's where you're going to see the logo, Outlier New NYC.
I price them too cheap, I don't know.
No, they're a hot commodity right now.
I didn't realize. I was talking to my son and he was saying, no one's gonna really buy those. I go, really?
And shoot, yeah. You don't have any more in the house or any systems or anything?
You know what? We've got some that, look these are.
Exactly.
Well, hey, Dad!
So I still can't believe it was this Goodwill right behind me.